Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, it is a pleasure to welcome you to The Hague for our very first conference on blockchain. If ever there was a time to discuss the impact of this technology, it is now. The fourth industrial revolution is gaining more and more momentum, and everyone in IP has to get to grips with the technologies that are driving this period of great change and to understand their impact. Earlier this year in May, we did exactly that by holding a large conference on artificial intelligence, the first of its kind by a patent office in Europe. Today's event builds upon that conference by discussing another key component of 4IR, which is developing rapidly, blockchain. In the same way as we did for AI, we are here today principally to discuss the patenting of this technology, and one major aim is to give applicants better knowledge around the drafting of blockchain applications. But why now? A little later today, you're going to hear from our chief economist, and he's going to talk about some of the trends we are seeing in blockchain filings and applications. But the long and the short of it is this: patent applications for this technology are rising. And they are rising very fast. Particularly in the last 2 years, we have seen a very sharp increase. It's happening in Europe, and it's happening in a host of other territories. And the number of filings is expected to grow further. The fields in which blockchain technology is being used is also expanding rapidly. Inventors and programmers are quickly discovering many creative ways in which it can be applied. Keeping patient records in the health industry, vehicles with embedded technology, changes in the finance industry, insurance claims, supply chains, and blockchain-powered IP trading platforms. The list goes on. All in all, we are looking at more patent applications in more technological fields. We can't tell how this technology or its patent landscape is going to evolve in the future with absolute certainty. And it's true that the number of filings is still relatively small compared with other technologies. But what we can do is prepare for the changes and trends we are seeing now and to anticipate growth in the future. One element of that is making sure we are prepared as a patent granting authority to efficiently grant blockchain patents that are legally robust. And I'm pleased to say our ability to grant these patents in a predictable manner is well underway. After all, blockchain inventions are computer-implemented inventions, so they are examined by the EPO according to very stable criteria developed on the basis of CII case law. Our examination guidelines are constantly reviewed and adapted in order to make this criteria clear, both to examiners and external stakeholders. In addition, the EPO's three-member examining divisions that we have in place allows for an efficient examination of often cross-disciplinary blockchain patent applications. And we will continue to develop our training and competencies to ensure EPO examiners can excel in their work. But another element of our preparation is to reach out to our users, to make sure we are doing everything we can to help them in the patent application process for blockchain. The EPO has always faced future challenges with our users in close dialogue and developed our services in response to their needs. So this conference has been designed to give everyone a full understanding of the patent application process at EPO for blockchain. Some of you are highly experienced with the European patent system, and some may be relatively new users. But regardless of your knowledge of the European patent system, we are aiming to provide clarification and insight for everyone on our patent grant process and how to draft claims in this relatively new but rapidly expanding field. Today, we also want to continue to develop a shared understanding of the issues that are relevant to both of us, EPO, staff, and users alike. If you look at the agenda, you will see it's been developed to give us an opportunity to look at a range of associated subjects, subjects such as the fields of application for blockchain, its future impact, and searching blockchain patents, as well as how patent applications are developing in other parts of the world, such as China. I will close by saying that this may be a highly dynamic subject, but we have here today a wide range of stakeholders who can all contribute knowledge and expertise. We have got EPO experts from all our sides to ensure the EPO has a fully coordinated approach, institutional partners such as the European Commission, national patent offices, user associations, academia, industry representatives, IP attorneys, and many more. It's the perfect occasion to learn how the challenge of patenting blockchain becomes an opportunity for all of us. So thank you very much and enjoy the conference. Thank you.